Now let us look at the question number 3 here, and actually this question number 3 is very interesting because again you should know all these terminologies, all these 4 statements one by one, and actually these 4 statements are basically theorems. So these theorems are already there, so you just need to know to solve this question, just need to know these theorems. If you do not know these theorems, you will not be able to solve it. Okay, so we'll read the theorems one by one, but again, to explain any theorem in complete details, it will take a lot of time. So I'm not giving you a proper explanation, but wherever it is necessary, for example, here I should know what is an atom, right? And what is it labeled acyclic digraph? So what is a digraph? So we should know some of these terminologies. So wherever it is necessary to understand the terminologies, we will try to understand it. Otherwise, I'll give you separate videos for this complete explanation of this question number 3. But let us see what is the correct answer for this question number 3. So the question number 3 is saying, which of the following statements are true? We have to tell which of the followings are true, correct? So first statement is, every logic network is equivalent to one using just NAND gate or just NOR gate. Now you should know that NAND gate and NOR gate are functionally complete. Now because they are functionally complete, that is why any circuit, any logical circuit that you may have, that logical circuit can be represented just by using a NAND gate or just by using a NOR gate. With the help of just NAND gate, you can represent AND gate, you can represent OR gate, you can represent NOT gate. You can make all these 3 gates just by using a NAND gate. That is why even if I give you any circuit, so you can replace all the gates just by using this NAND gates or just by NOR gate, and you can make an equivalent circuit. So that is why the option number 1, that statement number 1 is true. Okay, so this is true. Now look at the statement number 2. It is saying, the Boolean expressions and the logic networks correspond to labeled acyclic graph. Actually, this is also true, and this is a previous year question. I don't remember it, but I think it was asked in UGCNET 2015. You may check the UGCNET 2015 question paper. In 2015, they given the exactly the same statement, and this was also true. The third statement, they are saying, no two Boolean algebras with n atoms are isomorphic. So first of all, you should know, here we are discussing about the Boolean algebra. We are not discussing about the Boolean circuit. Okay, so we should know what is a Boolean algebra. And secondly, we should know what are atoms in a Boolean algebra and what is an isomorphic Boolean algebra. So this is actually given a theorem. This theorem, they're just given the statement of a theorem, and this is perfectly fine. But let us see what is the Boolean algebra. So in a Boolean algebra, there are first of all, there should be some underlying sets. For example, that can be set of numbers, that can be some set of, you know, we can have a underlying set. It can be, for example, the set can be having a numbers which is 0 or 1. Secondly, we should have some operations. We should have 2 binary operations and 1 unary operation. So for example, here this is the AND, this is OR, and this is negation. So this is representing a Boolean algebra. Even if you try to represent an algebra like this, we have something, a set, we have union, we have intersection, and we have negation. Now this is also representing a Boolean algebra. So in a Boolean algebra, we should have 2 binary operation, 1 unary operator, and then we have underlined set on which you are performing this operation. And a part of this, there should exist a unity element, there should exist a zero of the set. So if you have studied this Boolean algebra in detail before, I think if you have studied from my videos, I've already explained this Boolean algebra in complete details before. So you should know what are all these things. So any Boolean algebra should follow certain properties. For example, it should follow associativity, it should follow commutativity, it should follow distributivity, it should follow identity element, there should be an idempotency property should be satisfied, absorption should be satisfied, complementation should be satisfied. There are certain kind of properties which any Boolean algebra should follow. It is not like we are just having only one kind of Boolean algebra. We can have many Boolean algebra. For example, there is a Boolean algebra which is based on this this logic, which is dot as well as OR, and we have complementation. A part of this, you can also create a Boolean algebra using this union, intersection, and complementation. So you can have Boolean algebra using this AND, OR, and NOT. So there are various Boolean algebras which are having some underlying set. They are having some zero of the element, zero of the set. They are having one of the set, two binary operations and one unary operation. That algebra is called as a Boolean algebra. Now the elements of this Boolean algebra can also be represented using a lattice. So you should know what is a lattice. So for example, I can represent a Boolean lattice like this. So this is the one of the algebra. So these are the various elements in the lattice. Okay, so this is, for example, this is A2. So this lattice is generally represented in the form of a cube in case of Boolean algebra. Fine. I think you already have an idea what is a lattice. Fine. Now in this lattice, you can see this is the zero of the set. Now every immediate successor here, whether it is A1, whether it is A2, whether it is A3, all these immediate successors, they are called as the atoms. Now in the question they are saying, no two Boolean algebras with n atoms are isomorphic. Actually this is false. These two are true and this is false, because this is a basic property that first of all, you should know what are atoms. So these are immediate successors, they are atoms. And every Boolean algebra which is having 2 raised to the power n elements, for some elements which are called as n generators or called as atoms. Okay. And every finite Boolean algebra is isomorphic. So you should know this theorem. Let me just write it down so that you can note it in your notebook. Every finite Boolean algebra is isomorphic. I'm not giving you a proper complete definitions here, because if I give you, then it will become like 2 hours lectures, not a single video. So I'll make a different separate lecture to explain this entire question. So isomorphic to an algebra of sets. Okay, so this is false. And if you see, 1 and 2 they are true, 3rd is false, and 4th I have not seen the 4th one yet. But again, we can see the 4th one also. But let us see what are the options. Can we solve this question just by looking at the first 3 statements here? So here you can see the options are, the first option is 1, 2 and 3 only, they are true. But here you can see 3 is not true, so this is wrong. In the second option, 2, 3 and 4. So you can see 2 is true, 3 is wrong. The third option is 1 and 2, that is correct, right? And the fourth option is 1 and 4. So because they are not mentioning 2 here, that is why it is also wrong. So because 1 and 2 both are correct. So I feel even without looking at option number 4, I can say the option number 4 is false because of the options that they have given. So here only statement number 1 and 2, they are correct. And statement number 3 and 4, they are false. Fine, I have not seen the option number 4 till now, but we can see the option number 4. That is not a big issue, right? So we should know all these basic terminologies, because even without knowing the terminologies, we will not be able to solve this question. Okay, now let us move on to the next question here.